Generations and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. Beside you. Oh.
all around you, within you. He is in me, he is in me. In the morning, in the evening, in your coming, in your going, your rejoicing, he is for me. May the favor, may the favor
be upon you.
Morning, church. Okay, if you have someone at home with you, why not turn around to them and say shalom? Alright, it's exactly 2 months since the Movement Control Order, MCO, has started on the 18th of March 2020. I believe that since then, you know, some of you have recently gone back to work, while some of you are still staying home. There's a likelihood we still may not be able to resume our physical church services and ministries so soon. So, I want to encourage you, while you are still at home, you know, when you have the time, to continue to draw close to the Lord, read the Word of God, pray, and continue to be fervent in your faith in the Lord. But please allow me to update you on a few things here. Firstly, the COVID-19 Benevolent Fund. We want to thank God that some of you have contributed to this fund. Keep it up. I'm so encouraged to know that, you know, the funds are coming in. I can really see that you, all of you, who are so generous, contributing towards this cause. And if the Holy Spirit impresses upon your heart, please feel free to continue to contribute to this cause. As a family of God, we hope that we can reach out and help those in need. I would like to also put on record a word of appreciation, especially to our COVID-19 task force, who have worked hard over these few months. And over these past few months, we have also been able to help a few families. And we hope that with more funds coming in, we are able to help many more families who are in need. Secondly, media team. In view of the fact that we may need to continue with online services and ministries for some time, we need more help in the media team. So calling all young people and all those who are creative, all those who are talented, you may not be so young, but you are good in this. You know, you can take videos, photos, design posters, create YouTube videos, etc. Please avail yourselves. Do to talk to Marianne or myself, so that we can actually get in touch with you, connect with you, and see how you can involve yourself in the media team. We certainly appreciate your services unto the Lord. Thirdly, this is regarding the cell groups. In the foreseeable future, cell groups will play a very important role, as mass gatherings may not be permitted for some time. As such, we strongly encourage you to be part of a cell group. Even when we can meet in future, we may still be meeting in smaller group settings such as cell groups. So if you are not sure which cell group to join, please feel free to get in touch with the church leaders or myself, and we will definitely help you to be connected with a cell group. And last but not least, this is regarding the hand copying scriptures challenge. Well, it's already mid-May. I'm so proud to say that, you know, we have quite a number who have already completed this challenge. So if you have not completed, you still have about a month or so to complete this hand copying of the book of Acts. So for those of you who have completed, congratulations, well done. and a mystery gift awaits you when we return to our church premises soon. So in the meanwhile, for those who have not finished, you have still got some time to catch up. For those who have completed, you can also always copy more books in the Bible. Okay, there are so many more books that you can copy and you will surely be blessed. Right now, I'd like to introduce to you our guest speaker for this morning. Our guest speaker today is not a stranger to many of you. Gideon Tan is actually my nephew, but let me give you a brief profile to introduce him to you. Well, Gideon Tan is married to Evelyn Koh since 2015. He has a master's in mechanical engineering. He has obtained steam engineering and professional engineering qualifications. He has recently completed the doctorate in business administration. He serves with his wife in the worship team, the Young Adults Fellowship and Bible Study Ministry. He teaches drums and guitar to equip the worship ministry team members. And to make learning simpler, he created a YouTube channel for basic worship guitar lessons. Besides that, he has also got a passion to find ways to make the Bible very interesting using comics. Do you know that he's really good in drawing comics as well? Well, these are shown in his comic and dietary website, Try It Out Lah. Okay, Try It Out Lah with the Malaysian L-A-H. So you can just Google Try It Out Lah and you can find out so many useful resources there. Bible commentaries, websites and designs and songs and all that. So many interesting things that you can find that he has compiled together, some of which are his own, some of which he shared compiled together. So without further ado, let's put our hands together to welcome Gideon Tan and Evelyn Koh as they present the message, Audience.
Shalom. Thank you, Pastor Timothy, for giving Evelyn and me a chance to share once again with you.
平安, 感谢 Pastor Timothy 又让, 给我们这个机会, 可以跟大家一起来分享。
I hope all of you are doing well in this period of post and mid MCO.
希望大家在这个行动管制期间呢, 大家都能够有健康。
Let's continue to remember those who are in need.
让我们也能够纪念到那些有需要的。
Okay, with this, let's pray.
让我们一起来祷告。
Our Heavenly Father, thank you for blessing and providing us in this period of MCO.
亲爱的阿爸天父, 感谢你这段时间对我们的保守和看顾。
We want to pray for our country's economy and for all those who are at the front line treating the patients.
我们为这在我们前线为我们工作的这些医护人员, 也为着我们国家的经济和政治来祷告。
We pray that you teach us to not look only into our own interests, but to the interests of others.
主帮助我们, 让我们不单单顾念自己的事, 也能够顾念别人的事。
In Jesus' mighty name we pray, Amen.
祷告奉主耶稣的名求的, Amen.
Okay, so today my sharing is entitled Audience.
所以今天呢, 要分享的题目呢, 是 Audience, 观众。
Okay, all of us know this app, right?
相信大家都知道这个软件, 对吗?
I believe this is being clicked on multiple times a day on your phone.
我想大家都能够在自己的手机都有这个面子书, 然后每天都应该会上去按几次。
These are the next two famous apps that some of us use more than the others.
以上这两个呢, 又是另外两个社交软件, 大家也会常常用的。
There are of course many more apps.
当然还有其他很多我们常常使用的软件。
These are what we term as social apps.
这些就是我们说的社交软件。
We communicate, interact, comment, and show our opinions on these apps.
我们可以在这些社交软件上面呢, 能够写自己的意见, 能够来啊, 喜欢啊, 不喜欢啊, 能够跟其他人来交流。
Many people use these apps for various reasons, but what are we looking for with this?
每个人呢, 用这些社交软件呢, 都有不同的原因, 可是我们自己呢, 我们用的时候呢, 我们想要达到的目的是什么呢?
Okay, one of the reasons is for us to check and see who agrees with us, supports us, and of course, disagrees and criticizes.
当然呢, 这些媒体软件呢, 当我们发表一些言论或者post一些图片的时候呢, 我们可以知道有谁是赞同我们的, 有些是支持我们, 相对的, 有谁是不同意, 不喜欢的。
We can see it here in the likes and subscribe.
我们可以追踪到呢, 到底有几个人like我们的po文。 有多少人呢已经 subscribe 了，订阅了我们的频道。
In all, we are looking for an audience.
总的来说呢，就是我们呢都其实都寻求在有谁关注我们，我们的观众到底有谁呢？
A group of people that will be in sync with us with similar wavelengths.
当然这些关注我们的观众呢，就是会赞同我们的，喜欢我们所分享所 post 这些东西，和我们是同样在同样的这个 频道上的。
We want to belong to a group.
我们都想呢，通常呢都是在同一个群组里面。
The sense of belonging is very strong in us.
归属感呢都会有相同的归属感，因为大家喜欢的东西都是一样的。
But not all of us are superstars, and hence we will get less or probably no comments, likes or subscribe.
当然呢，我们每个人都不是网上的网红嘛，或者明星嘛。有时候呢，我们也没有这么多人来追踪我们，来 like 我们。
We don't feel belong to a group.
当我们呢，我们所 po 的 po 文呢，没有人喜欢，没有人按赞，我们就会觉得，哎，是不是没有人赞同我呢？
We feel lonely inside, and we ask ourselves, what if I don't have an audience? Does what I do matter? If I'm serving and nobody sees, does it matter?
这就让我们思考，当我所 po 的东西没有人按赞，没有人留言，那么是不是我所做的没有人在意呢？我是不是，你会不会有一种孤独的感觉呢？会不会是如果我做的什么东西都没有人关注，有这个必要吗？
Hey, don't worry, because actually we always have an audience.
可是别担心，无论我们做什么呢，我们都一定会有观众的。
And that can be good news if you are doing the right thing, and bad news if you are doing something bad.
当然呢，如果你所做的是好事呢，一定很开心有观众。可是呢，如果你所做的是坏事呢，你就要当心啦，因为有一个人会一直在看着你。
So the answer is of course God. God is our ultimate and permanent audience.
当然，那个观众是谁呢？就是上帝啦。
You have guessed that, right?
我想你们当中有些人应该已经猜到了。
C.S. Lewis once said.Integrity is doing the right thing even when no one is watching. I believe when he said no one, he meant no human being.
C.S. 路易斯曾经说呢，正直是当没有人看的时候呢，也做对的事情。
However, as we have discussed, we will always have God watching over us.
可是呢，正如刚刚我们所讨论的，无论我们在做什么事情呢，上帝呢都在看着我们。
And that is what my topic is today, audience.
所以呢，这就是我们今天信息的主题，观众。
Our audience is God with a capital A.
我们的观众呢是上帝。
Now the next question to ask ourselves is this: What would our audience, singular, wants to see?
那么呢，我们就想一想，我们这一位观众呢，到底他想看的是什么
？In other words, what is our audience?Interested to see. Remember the likes and the subscribe button.
容易的来说呢，就是我们这一位观众呢，他到底对我们的哪一方面有兴趣呢？他到底对我们所做的什么事情会按赞、会留言呢？
One thing for sure is that we can say that God is interested in holiness.
当然，我们第一点就可以说，上帝其实呢最关注、最感兴趣的就是我们的过圣洁的生活。
God definitely wants us to be holy, as He is holy.
上帝呢，也希望我们能够像他一样是圣洁的，因为他是圣洁的上帝。
One of such verses is found in 1 Peter 1 verse 6. Okay, I'll read it for you. For it is written, "Be holy, because I am holy."
正如彼得前书一章十六节所说的，因为经上记着说，你们要圣洁，因为我是圣洁的。
Now a question comes to our mind.How many times does the word holy appear in the Bible?
可是这时候你会想，诶，这样到底在圣经中呢，圣洁这个字眼出现了多少次呢？
The word holy appears 452 times in the NIV Bible.
在英文的 NIV 的圣经里面呢， holy 呢，圣洁这个字共出现了452次。
But if you use a different translation, you will get slightly different results.
当然如果你用不同一本的圣经呢，这个次数呢会有一些小小的不同。
But the proportion and percentage might be quite the same.
可是呢，我们可以知道这个比例还是一样的。
I've used Bible Gateway and online Bible website to do a quick search.
以上呢是我们用这个 Bible Gateway 这个网站呢所得出的结论。
Out of 452 times, the book of Leviticus has the highest word count for holy, as compared to other books like Isaiah, Psalms, Exodus, Ezekiel, or even Numbers.
所以呢，我们说452次嘛，当中出现最多的呢，就是在利未记，总共出现了83次。相对的来说，其他的书卷呢，好像以赛亚、诗篇、出埃及记、以西结跟民数记呢，也有出现，可是数目相对的少。
Therefore, it is only appropriate for us to dig a little into this book to know about holiness.
所以呢，我们会在利未记里面呢，更加来探讨到底什么是圣洁。
But before that, let's have a look at what.This book is all about.
首先我们先来了解什么是利未记。
Okay, the book of Leviticus can be categorized into 8 sections with the format that I drew.
利未记呢可以分成八个部分。
Okay, so I will first explain in English and Evelyn will explain it in Mandarin for you. Okay, so I based this upon Bible project and I added color to it.These sections, each of these sections actually parallel with each other. So for example, if you look at offerings, you're parallel with feasts. So both of these are ceremonies. The next part is chapter 8 to 10, parallel with 21 to 22. These are priests and priests, ordination of priests and regulation or rules for priests. The next one is chapter 11 to 15, which parallel with 17 to 20. This is the...code for cleanliness, this is the code for holiness. So you can see, this is like a sandwich, you see. So this parallel this, this and this, this and this. And then in the middle, we have the sort of patty, you know, the center of the sandwich. You have atonement, or what we call scapegoat. Of course, you have a final remark.
好，现在我们就来看一下这个利未记的结构。我们可以看到的利未记呢，我们说分成八个部分嘛，这里就有八个格子，代表八个部分。然后呢，第一到第七节呢是献祭，献祭呢就是有五个祭，这就对应了23到25节的节期，有七个节期，这个是仪式和仪式的这个对照。然后第二个部分我们可以看到的就是8到10节呢是承接嘛，祭司要有一个承接礼，就很像对照21到22章这里的关于祭司的一些条例。所以这个是第二个部分可以互相对照的。然后第三个呢是关于到洁净的条例，第11到15章有提到。当然呢17到20章呢也是有提到关于一些我们的道德条例啊，社会的条例，这些的律例。所以11到15章跟17到20章呢也是可以互相对应的。当然我们会看到这个格式很像一个汉堡包的格式嘛，因为上下两层都一样。当然中间呢就是16章了，就是说到替罪羊，这就很像我们汉堡包里面中间的那一块肉片。
Okay, now I will show you an actual hamburger and tell you. So if you can see this model, the bread, if you remember the picture before that, okay, this and this, offerings and feasts. So offerings and feasts, sacrifices and feasts, okay, this actually offerings. Then the next part is the lettuce, the vegetable.You have the priest and priest. So this is the ordination and also this is the regulations. And of course, you have the tomatoes, which is the cleanliness code and also holiness code. Finally, you have the patty, which is the scapegoat. So this is the structure.
所以呢，正如我们前面所谈到的呢，利未记呢就很像这个汉堡包的模式嘛，上面跟下面是互相对应的。所以我们看回那张汉堡包的图片。前面呢是讲到仪式，这个关系到献祭的有五种祭呢，后面呢是有讲到这个节期，再来呢就是讲到祭司的就职典礼，还有讲到关于祭司的一些条例，然后再下来是关系到要洁净的条例，还有对照呢我们要如何圣洁生活的这个社会的条例，当然中间呢就很像我们说的肉片，就是关系到替罪羊的。
Okay, don't worryWe will move on to the next one because we're not going to talk about everything today.
别担心，我们会接下来呢会详细的再说一些关于今天的主题。
What you need to know from this is the middle patty is the most important part because it's the scapegoat, it's the atonement, which is what is a shadow of Christ's atonement for us.
当然呢，你们只需要知道呢，在这一个汉堡包模式呢有一个重点，我们说最重要就是那个替罪羊嘛。替罪羊呢就很像预表的主耶稣基督呢，是为我们的罪代赎的，钉在十字架上的。
So now, after briefly knowing how the book of Leviticus laid out, we will turn our focus to just one portion of the book.
当然呢，我们说立位记有八个部分嘛，看到八个格子吗？可是今天我们分享的信息呢，主要是集中在第一到第七章关于献祭的这个部分。
We'll focus on the section that talks about ceremonial offering. Okay, this section covers Leviticus chapter 1 to 7, but we are not going to talk all about that.
当然呢，圣经一到七章关于献祭呢，有说了五种祭嘛。可是今天我们不会说这五种祭，我们只会专注在其中一种祭。
Okay, so now in Leviticus chapter 1 to 7, the section on ceremonial offering, there are a total of 5 offerings, as you can see over here.
立位记呢有五种祭，大家可以在图片中看到。
But I will not touch on all of them, but I will only touch on one offering, which is called the burnt offering right here.
今天我们要讨论的就是关于燔祭。
Circle over here. Okay, now, you might ask, wait a minute. What has this to do with holiness to our audience? I mean, in other words, what has this, you know, to do withOur holy living with our audience, which is God.
Okay, 现在我们就会要来问一个问题是，诶，圣洁和我们的观众有什么关系呢？大家还记得我们的观众是谁吗？对了，就是我们的上帝。这样子，圣洁和上帝到底有什么关系呢？
Okay. Our aim today is to live holy life, is to understand how to live holy life. For who? For our audience.
所以呢，我们今天要学习就是上帝呢对圣洁的角度到底是什么看法，上帝对圣洁的标准是什么，然后对照呢我们今天要讨论的立位记的这个燔祭。
So we'll be comparing and seeing what we can glean from the burnt offerings in Leviticus, the book that we might not go very often, as you know, might be quite boring to many, but honestly it's very interesting if you see the correlation.
立位记呢对很多人来讲可能是很陌生的，因为觉得诶会很无聊嘛，可是当你细细研读的时候呢，你会发现它很精彩。
So just to tell you, we are comparing holiness to burnt offering.
所以呢我们现在今天要看的就是对照呢圣洁还有这个立位记的燔祭里面我们来对照。
Now I'll propose 8 points for today's sharing, and this is the word audience.
所以呢，今天主题信息呢有八个重点，我们就用这个 audience 这个观众呢，这八个字母呢来代表八个重点。
This is a word that we mentioned earlier, and it's the title of my sharing. But each letter here will be a point that I will make.
有八个字嘛 ，audience 八个字母，所以八个字母代表有八个重点。
But before that, let's read today's passage, and it's taken from Leviticus chapter 1, verse 1 to 13.
让我们一起的来读今天所要分享的经节，记载在立位记第一章一到十三节。
I'll read in English and then Evelyn will read in Mandarin, so we'll read 3 verses each.
我们呢会先开始读三节英语，再接着三节华语的。
The Lord called Moses and spoke to him from the tent of meeting. He said, Speak to the Israelites and say to them, When anyone among you brings an offering to the Lord, bring as your offering an animal from either the herd or the flock.If the offering is a burnt offering from the herd, you are to offer a meal without defect. You must present it at the entrance of the tent of meeting so that it will be acceptable to the Lord.
立位记第一章一到三节，耶和华从会幕中呼叫摩西，对他说：你晓谕以色列人说，你们中间若有人献供物给耶和华，要从牛群、羊群中献牲畜为供物。他的公物若以牛为燔祭，就要在会幕门口献一只没有残疾的公牛，可以在耶和华面前蒙悦纳。
Verse 4, chapter 1, verse 4, you are to lay your hand on the head of the burnt offering, and it will be acceptable to your behalf to make atonement for you. You are to slaughter the young bull before the Lord, and then Aaron's son, the priest, shall bring the blood and splash it against the side of the altar at the entrance of the tent of meeting.You are to skin the burnt offering and cut it into pieces.
立位记第一章第四到六节，他要按手在燔祭神的头上，燔祭便蒙悦纳，为他赎罪。他要在耶和华面前宰公牛，亚伦子孙做祭司的要奉上血，把血洒在会幕门口坛的周围。那人要剥去燔祭神的皮，把燔祭神切成筷子。
Verse 7.The sons of Aaron the priest are to put fire on the altar and arrange wood on the fire. Then Aaron's sons the priest shall arrange the pieces, including the head and the fat, on the wood that is burning on the altar. You are to wash the internal organs and the legs with water, and the priest is to burn all of it on the altar. It is a burnt offering, a food offering, an aroma pleasing to the Lord.
利未记第一章第七到九节，祭司亚伦的子孙要把火放在坛上，把柴摆在火上。亚伦子孙做祭司的要把肉块和头并脂油摆在坛上火的柴上，但燔祭的丈夫与腿要用水洗，祭司就要把一切全烧在坛上，当作燔祭献于耶和华为馨香的火祭。
Chapter 1 verse 10 to 12. If the offering is a burnt offering from the flock, from either the sheep or the goats, you are to offer a male without defect. You are to slaughter itAt the north side of the altar before the Lord, and Aaron's son, the priest, shall splash its blood against the sides of the altar. You are to cut it into pieces, and the priest shall arrange them, including the head and the fat, on the wood that is burning on the altar.
利未记第一章第十到十二节，人的供物若以绵羊或山羊为燔祭，就要献上没有残疾的公羊，要把羊宰于坛的北边，在耶和华面前。亚伦子孙做祭司的要把羊血撒在坛的周围，要把燔祭绳切成筷子，连头和脂油，祭司就要摆在坛上火的柴上。
Finally, Leviticus chapter 1 verse 13, you are to wash the internal organs and the legs with water, and the priest is to bring all of them and burn them on the altar. It is a burnt offering, a food offering, an aroma pleasing to the Lord.
利未记第一章第十三节，但丈夫与腿要用水洗，祭司就要全然奉献，烧在坛上。这是燔祭，是献于耶和华为馨香的火祭。
Alright, so now the first point on holy living is the word atonement from the first letter of audience A.
所以今天呢，我们的第一个重点呢是 A atonement 赎罪。
Okay, this is taken from Leviticus chapter 1 verse 4, the one we have written. We'll read together again.You are to lay your hand on the head of the burnt offering, and it will be acceptable on your behalf to make atonement for you.
正如利未记一章四节这样说，他要按手在燔祭绳的头上，燔祭便蒙悦纳，为他赎罪。
So the first point is very simple. In order to be able to start to live holy lives, we need to acknowledge that Christ has made atonement for our sins.
所以呢，第一点呢。我们要过一个圣洁的生活呢，首先呢，我们就必须承认主耶稣就是很像我们的替罪羊，他为我们赎罪。
The second letter is you, unblemished.
第二个重点呢，就是没有残疾。
Okay, so my second point actually means without defect.
没有残疾呢，就代表呢，就是没有任何的残缺，没有任何的缺点，在这个祭绳上面。
In the Greek word.It means, sin means missing the mark. So in this picture, we can see that the arrow does not miss the mark. No defect.
在这个希腊文呢，这个呢，这个词呢，其实就是说，就是没有偏离嘛，就是正中红心嘛。所以我们可以看到这个图片呢，就是我们射箭嘛，就是一把射中红心了。
So this is taken from verse 3. I'll read it in English. In the offering,If the offering is a burnt offering from the herd, you are to offer a male without defect. That's the key word. You must present it at the entrance to the tent of meeting so that it will be acceptable to the Lord.
利未记一章三节这样说，他的供物若以牛为燔祭，就要在会幕门口献一只没有残疾的公牛，可以在耶和华面前蒙悦纳。
So what this means is that Christ is perfect, okay, not us, and he is offered on our behalf to soothe God's anger on us, we as sinners.
所以这里的意思就是说呢，我们献上没有残疾的这个祭神嘛，就很像主耶稣基督，因为他是完全的，所以呢，他就是为了我们，代替我们，为我们的罪钉在十字架上。
So in other words, Christ allows God to make peace with us.
所以换句话来说呢，就是主耶稣基督成为我们的中保，他代替我们，让我们能够与神和好。
Remember what the angel said during Christmas?
大家记得天使在报佳音的时候说了什么吗？
I'll read to you, this is taken from Luke actually. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests.
路加福音二章十四节呢，天使说在至高之处荣耀归于神，在地上平安归于他所喜悦的人。
God's favor rests on us not because of our good works, but the work of Christ alone.
我们知道呢，在这里呢，地上平安呢，归于我们呢，不是因为我们的好行为，而是因为有主耶稣基督，他降生了，透过他呢，上帝的平安才临到我们。
My next letter is D, which stands for dice.
接下来第三个重点呢，就是剖皮切块。
Yes, you can see a person dicing the meat.
图片呢，我们看到有一个人在切这个肉块。
Let's look at the verse. You are to skin the burnt offering and cut it into pieces, Leviticus 1 verse 6.
利未记一章六节这样说：那人要剖去燔祭牲的皮，把燔祭牲切成筷子。
What we can learn from here is that for holy living, we are to put aside all our glory and our old self.
所以呢，我们从这里学到的呢，为了要过圣洁的生活呢，我们呢要把自己的老我、自己的不好的自己呢剖去，很像剖皮这样。
The best part of the animal is their skin.
当然呢，对动物来说呢，它们有好处、有用处的地方是它们的皮。
So their skin is removed, just as our own good deeds and works are removed.
所以呢，在这里呢，就是燔祭牲的皮被剖去嘛，就很像说呢，我们所做的这些好事啊，我们所做的这些善功呢，要先脱去，就很像，肮脏的衣服要脱去。
Yeah, it's like.Our good works is like filthy rags, as stated in Isaiah 64, verse 6.
这就很像以赛亚书六十四章六节所说的。
So we should not boast of ourselves anymore.
所以呢，这就是说呢，我们不要因为自己所做的好事、好行为而自夸。
So that is taking away of the skin, yeah.
所以这就是说，所谓的把这个预表呢，把燔祭牲的皮剖去一样。
What about dicing?
那么切块呢？它预表什么呢
？Okay, dicing means we need to be broken before God can use us.
所以呢，这个切块呢，就是说我们要在神面前呢，把自己破碎，破碎自己。
As the psalmist says in Psalms 51 verse 17, My sacrifice, O God, is a broken spirit. A broken and contrite heart, you, God, will not despise.
正如诗篇51篇17节这么说，神所要的祭就是忧伤的灵。神啊，忧伤痛悔的心，你必不轻看。
What Christ has done for us ought to humble us as God opposes the proud.But shows favor to the humble.
雅各书呢，也是四章六节有这么说嘛，他就是说神阻挡骄傲的人，赐恩给谦卑的人。所以呢，这里说的切块呢，就是我们要把我们自己的这个骄傲的心而全部破碎掉。
The next letter is I, which stands for inner self.
接下来第四个重点呢，是关于到内心。
Let me read you the verse again. You are to wash the internal organs and the legs.With water, and the priest is to burn all of it on the altar. It is a burnt offering, a food offering, an aroma pleasing to the Lord.
利未记一章九节这样说：但燔祭的肾脏与腿要用水洗，祭司就要把一切全烧在坛上，当作燔祭，献于耶和华为馨香的火祭。
It happens that the word "inert" of the animal and our inner self both starts with the letter I.
我们知道，哎，动物的内脏还有我们内心的都是一样的，这是关于内嘛，里面嘛。
In this verse, we see that the internal organs are burned on the altar, given to God.
在这个经节里面，我们看到呢，燔祭的这些内脏呢，就是肾脏呢，都要把一切都要用火烧在坛上的。
And in this picture, we see the kidney of a calf.
在这个图片里面呢，我们可以看到是一只牛犊的这个肾脏。
It's interesting that in Hebrew language, you fill with your kidney, not with your heart, like in English.
在这个希伯来文呢，他们感觉的不像我们华人是用内心的，他们的感觉呢是用这个肾脏来感觉的。
So we can equate by saying that we ought to give our emotional self to God in order to start a holy living.
所以呢，这就是好像预表呢，我们要把我们全然的自己，把我们全心都献给神。
The next letter that I want to tell you is E.
第五个重点呢是全部
，which is everything. Okay, so let's look at the verse. You are to wash the internal organs and the legs with water, and the priest is to burn all. So the word keyword here is all of it on the altar. It is a burnt offering, a food offering, an aroma pleasing to the Lord, as the verse before.
利未记一章九节呢，这么样说：但燔祭的肾脏与腿要用水洗，祭司就要把一切全烧在坛上，当作燔祭，献于耶和华为馨香的火祭。
So, from the previous picture, you can see the mind, the energy as a light bulb, and also time. And the following slide, you can see money. So, actually, actually this means we need to give all of that from of our possession to God.
大家呢可以看在前面这张 slide 里面，我们看到嘛，就是呢我们的脉，我们的整个的思想，然后我们所有的精力，我们全部的时间，还有呢我们全部的金钱，全部的财富呢，都要献给神，很像牲畜这样子，把全部的都烧在坛上。
So giving all to God does not, it's not confined by the four walls of the church, but includes our workplace, community, and family.
当然呢，我们说把这些全部献上呢，不只是在教会里面而已，当然也包括我们在我们的工作上面，在我们的社区里面，在我们的家人身上，我们都要付出全部。
What it signifies is also that we ought to give ourselves wholly to the Lord, not to have any reservation for sin.
这就是说呢，我们要把自己全然摆上，献给神，毫无保留的把自己献给神为活祭。
Okay, so the next one we have is N, number one.
接下来呢，第六个重点呢，就是最好的。
So from this picture, you can see three chefs paying their utmost attention to the preparation of their dishes. These three of them.
所以呢，在这张图片我们看到呢，有三个厨师嘛，你看他们都全神贯注的，大家都很努力的要把最好的菜肴呢摆设好端上去。
They want to present their best, and that should be our attitude.
当他们像他们这种呢，要把最好的摆上的时候呢，这就是像我们应该要学习的功课，把我们最好的献上给神。
Okay, what is said in verse 8 is then Aaron's son.The priest shall arrange the pieces, including the head and the fat, on the wood that is burning on the altar.
利未记一章八节呢，这么说：亚伦子孙做祭司的，要把肉块和头并腿油摆在坛上火的柴上。
So fat is one of the best part in an animal.
这里说到脂油嘛，其实脂油呢是在动物里面呢最上好最好的部分。
This picture here shows the fat.That are removed from the animal after the slaughter.
这个图片呢，所大家看到的呢，就是当我们把祭牲宰杀后呢，从它身上取出来的这个油脂。
Some commentators say that God gives the instruction to the Jewish people not to eat the fat for the reason that they don't want them to have heart attack and to have high cholesterol.
有些解经家会这么说，就是上帝呢要以色列人呢把这些脂油献给神，而是没有去吃它，就是因为要让他们有健康的身体嘛，就让他们能够少这些心脏病还有高胆固醇的这些疾病。
Some even say that the purpose is to prolong their lineage, you know, from the ancient time till the coming of the birth of Jesus Christ.
有些解经家呢，甚至会说呢，因为要让这些以色列人呢有好的这些饮食习惯，不吃油脂嘛，这样子他们的后代才会延续，直到耶稣基督的降生。
This is an interesting point of view.
这是蛮有趣的一个观点。
But we must also understand that fat is one of the most precious part of the local delicacy.
可是呢，我们也要知道呢，这个脂油呢不是说不健康哦、不好哦，所以才给神，因为呢，这个是最上好的部分，所以我们要把这个最上好的献给上帝。
So.In order for us to have holy living, we need to give God our number one, the best.
所以呢，我们要如何过圣洁的生活呢？那就是我们要把我们最好的献上给神。
The second last letter that we have is C, stands for continuous or unceasing.
第七个要点呢，也就是说持续不断。
So you can see a continuous or unceasing fire in the picture.
从这个图片大家可以看到，就是一个永不熄灭的火一直在燃烧着。
Do you know that the fire on the altar never subsides?
你们知道，在以色列人呢会幕里面的那个火呢是永远不会熄灭的吗？
Now you jump to chapter 6 of Leviticus on the burnt offering.
现在我们来看一下利未记六章十三节怎么说。
The fire must be kept burning on the altar continuously. It must not go out. Leviticus 6 verse 13.
利未记六章十三节呢这样说，在坛上必有常常烧着的火，不可熄灭。
This means that the priest is to keep the fire continually burning on the altar.
所以呢，这就很像呢，祭司呢要常常呢，确保呢，在坛上的火呢要常常烧，不可以有停的。
This means that a holy life requires us to continually be passionate and on fire for God.
这就提醒我们呢，也很像要这个常常烧着的火一样嘛，我们要常常持续不断的为主发热心。
But how can that be? Because we know that it is impossible on human standards.
可是我们要怎么才能够办到呢？因为我们知道，对人以人的角度来讲，我们没有能力能够常常的保持这个火热的心，为主发热心。
Let's look at what Apostle Paul says.
让我们看一看这个使徒保罗怎么说。
Apostle Paul says, For I know that good itself does not dwell in me, that is, in my sinful nature. For I have the desire to do what is good, but I cannot carry it out.
罗马书呢七章十八节这样说，我也知道在我里头就是我肉体之中没有良善，因为立志为善由得我，只是行出来由不得我。
Okay, so Paul did not end here, thank God. But in the next section, he actually says something else.
我们很感恩，因为保罗呢，使徒保罗不是到这里说就停止了，还有继续再说一些话。
What Paul said in the next section is, Thanks be to God who delivers me through Jesus Christ our Lord.
使徒保罗在罗马书七章二十五节又提到，感谢神，靠着我们的主耶稣基督就能脱离了。
So we can see this is a victorious claim of life.
所以我们知道了这是一个胜利的宣言嘛，因为靠着主耶稣基督，我们就可以战胜这些私欲啊，这些软弱。
And in fact, in the book of Philippians, it says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
再来呢，在这个腓立比书呢，保罗也有提到，我靠着那加给我力量的，凡事都能做。
Yes.So finally, our last letter here is the result of the holy living.
当然了，最后一个要点呢，就是呢，我们过圣洁生活的这个结果，那么就是我们会有丰盛的生命。
Yes, our life will be enriched if we live a holy life. So let's turn to the New Testament, to the book of John 10, verse 10.
现在呢，让我们来读一处经节，记载在约翰福音十章十节。
The thief comes only to steal.And kill and destroy. I've come that they may have life and have it to the full.
盗贼来无非要偷窃、杀害、毁坏。我来了是要叫羊得生命，并且得得更丰盛。
I like it because in Mandarin, "have it to the full" is translated as "function." Okay, this brings a connotation of the sumptuous meal you eat during Chinese New Year reunion dinner. You know.As seen in the picture.
当我们讲到丰盛的时候呢，我想多数人会想到很像我们新年华人过新年的时候会吃一个很丰盛的晚餐，就很丰盛的餐啊。你可以看到在图片这样子，有鱼啊，有肉啊，很丰富。
What this means is that our lives will be more abundant if we follow what God proposes us to live. You know, the holy life.
所以呢，这就是说，如果我们遵行神的话，我们过圣洁的生活呢，我们的生命也会很丰盛。
Remember, it is not true that holy things are boring and all unholy things are exciting. It's not true.
大家要记得哦，不是说如果我们过圣洁的生活呢，就会很无趣、很乏味，一点都不刺激，这些都是不对的。
Holy living can be exciting also.
圣洁生活呢，也是可以很丰富的。
We pray that God will shed light on us on this matter.
我们求神能够加添给我们力量来过这个丰盛的生活。
Finally, we are back to our title, audience.
所以呢，我们又回到我们今天分享信息的主题，观众。
We need to remember that God is our ultimate and permanent audience.
我们要记得，上帝呢是我们呢，永久的，常常会待在我们身边关注、看顾我们的观众。
So in order to live a holy life, we ought to do the eight things, the seven things actually.
所以呢，我们要如何过圣洁的生活呢？所以总共呢有几项重点，让我们来一起来复习。
Yeah, seven things and one result, yeah.So, first, we need to understand that we need to know that Christ's unblemished sacrifice allow me to make peace with God.
所以呢，我们要知道呢，第一点呢，就是上帝为我们赎罪嘛。
Sorry, let me begin again. The first point is, I need to know that Christ has died for my sins, atonement.
所以第一点就是我们要确实的知道呢，主耶稣基督呢为我们赎罪。
The second point is I need to know that Christ's unblemished sacrifice allows me to make peace with God.
第二点呢，就是呢，我们知道主耶稣基督他没有残疾的这个牺牲呢，让我们能够与神和好。
The third point is I need to be humble and put away my pride and arrogance.
第三点就是呢，我们要学习谦卑，把我们这些骄傲啊。这些高傲的心态呢，全部都除去。
The fourth point is I need to submit my inner self, including my emotional self, to God.
第四呢，就是说我们要把我们自己的全心呢，把我们内心，把我们全部的情感呢，都能够交托给神。
The fifth point is I need to give my everything to His service.
第五呢，就是说我们要很像燔祭这样子，把全部的，把自己全人的都献给神。
The sixth point is I need to give God my best, my number one.
第六点呢，就是我们要把我们最好的献给神。
Seventh point, I need to continually burn with passion for God by the power of the Holy Spirit.
第七点就是呢，我们要持续不断的为主发热心，靠着圣灵加添给我们的力量。
And with that, my life will be enriched, and I can live in abundance.
当我们都有符合以上的这七点呢，它的 结果就是呢，我们会有丰盛的生命。
So what shall we do today?
所以我们今天可以做什么呢？
We should follow what the Apostle Paul says.
我们应该来听从跟从使徒保罗所分享的。
Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Romans 12 verse 1.
所以弟兄们，我以神的慈悲劝你们，将身体献上，当作活祭，是圣洁的，是神所喜悦的。你们如此侍奉，乃是理所当然的。这是保罗在罗马书十二章一节所说的。
So thank you very much for listening, and God bless you. Have a good weekend.
愿今天的分享呢，对大家都带来帮助。愿上帝赐福给大家。
Well, church friends, I trust that all of you have been blessed, have been encouraged by today's message. We all worship and serve the audience of one, the one true God and Creator. Before we end today's service, allow me to speak to some of you here. I feel that there's a few categories of needs who are in the midst of us today. Firstly, I sense that some of you, you may be troubled emotionally and spiritually. But the Lord wants you to submit your inner self to Him and give Him your everything. Give Him your all, even your problems, your burdens, your talents, everything. Give Him all and allow Him to take over. This morning, I'd like to just encourage you to surrender to the Lord. Secondly, there's some of us who are hesitating to give God our best. God has given you many talents, gifts, resources, but yet you feel that you are holding back. The Lord wants you to be free. He wants us to be wholehearted, not half-hearted. I want to challenge you. Make a fresh commitment to give of your entire life to Him. And you will see that God is going to really reward you. He will not shortchange you when you give your everything to Him. Thirdly, in some of us here, over this past 2 months or so, you've been feeling dry, perhaps feeling burnout, feeling very discouraged. The Holy Spirit wants to do a new, deeper work in you, so that you can continually burn with passion. You can burn with passion and experience an enriched life in Him. And if that is you, I'd like you to respond to Him. I'd like you to make a response to Him so that God can touch you and God can just rekindle that fire, that flame within you. A few of you who are watching this online service here, you might not have received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Our Lord Jesus Christ has died and atoned for our sins, for your sins and my sins. He has died as the unblemished, perfect sacrifice, so that He can give us that eternal and abundant life in Him. Friends, would you be willing to invite Him into your life to be your personal Lord and Savior and receive this eternal life that He promised? And I really want to assure you that you will never regret making this very important decision of your life. When you give of your life to receive Him, you will truly see a transformation. Your life is going to be so enriched, and you are going to experience His presence, His peace in a very special manner. Would you be willing to do that? So I'd like to just pray right now before we go into a closing song. For those of you who have listened to this message, you can identify with some of these needs. I want you to right now just lift up your hands to the Lord. I'd like to pray with you for the first few categories of people, especially Christians. You are troubled emotionally, spiritually. You are hesitant to give God your best, or feeling dry, burnout. Just lift up your hands to God as I pray for you right now. Hallelujah. Oh, shikarababakasikarabakasanai. Oh, rababakasanai. Almighty God and loving Heavenly Father, even this day as we come before You, we acknowledge You, God. You are the true and living God. You are awesome, majestic, and worthy to be praised, worthy to be worshipped, O God. And You are beautiful beyond description. Oh, this day, O God, as we come before You, Lord, You know those who are feeling trouble emotionally and spiritually, O God. Lord, your word says, God, come to me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. So I want to pray for your people right now, for those who are burdened, oh God. Oh yes, oh God, Lord, set them free, that they are able, oh God, to surrender and submit their inner selves to you, oh God. And Lord, you will take over, you will intervene and cause breakthroughs to take place, oh God. Even right now, Father, in the name of Jesus, oh God, I want to reject and cast up, oh God, every spirit of fear, spirit of, oh yes, Lord, oh, discouragement, oh God. Oh yes, Lord, spirit of bitterness, spirit of unforgiveness, oh God. Oh yes, Lord, every spirit of restlessness, I take authority and cast them out in Jesus' name, oh God. I speak your peace and your shalom peace, your rest into them, oh God. And right now, for those, oh God, who are hesitant, oh God, to surrender and give of their best to you, Lord, you know, oh God, your people, oh God. Lord, I just want to pray, Father, that Lord, you will just help them, Father, to know, oh God, when they give of their lives and their everything to you wholeheartedly, you will not shortchange them, oh God. Oh, they will never outgive you, oh God. And so, Father, right now, I pray that you, your spirit will just minister to them, that they will be able, oh God, to make a fresh commitment, oh God, or to give of their whole lives to you. And Lord, I want to pray too, oh God, for those who are feeling dry spiritually, for those who have so many doubts and questions, for those on the verge of a burnout, oh God. Lord, I want to pray for your fresh touch right now. Come, Holy Spirit, move, oh God. Oh, yes, oh God. Yes, oh God. Lord, I want to pray, Lord, you will just fill them anew. Oh, fill them the fullness of your Holy Spirit, oh God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, oh God. Oh, touch your people. Touch your people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And for those of you who want to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, I'd like to invite you to just repeat in this very short and simple prayer with me. I believe that when you say this prayer with your heart, the Bible says, you know, if you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, you will be saved. And this is an opportunity to invite Jesus and let Him be the King, the Master, the Lord of your life. Just repeat after me in this very simple prayer. I'll say one sentence and you just follow after me. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for your love for me. Thank you for dying for me on the cross at Calvary. Thank you, Lord, that your blood cleanses me. Lord, I want to say I'm sorry. I admit that I'm a sinner. I confess of my sins that I've committed. Please forgive me. I right now invite you to be my Lord and my Savior. Come into my heart and take control of my life. Lord, I'm willing to follow you wholeheartedly. Please do be the Lord and Savior of my life and lead me into that enriched, abundant life. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. So if you have said that prayer, congratulations. We would like to welcome you into the family of God. Get in touch with us so that we can, you know, get to know you better and help you in your walk with the Lord. Alright, God bless you, and we would like to now proceed with our closing song.
Okay, now we will sing a closing song. From Romans chapter 12, verse 1 to 2. I've written it in Mandarin and English.
接下来呢, 让我们唱这首诗歌来回应。 这首诗歌呢, 是向义呢, 用罗马书 12章 1到2节的经文所写成的。
I will not conform any longer to the ways of the world, but be transformed by the renewing of my mind in Jesus Christ. I place myself on the altar as a living sacrifice. I place myself on the 基督的心为心，要借着心意你更新，透过圣灵改变我心，将自己献上当作活祭，圣洁而蒙神悦纳的，将自己献上当作活祭，圣洁而蒙神悦纳的。我祈求这是蒙福喜悦的。
Thank you and God bless.
谢谢，愿神赐福给大家。